An organization is not what it is just because of somebody's name and because of the talent they hold. It is the way they think. Bottom line, if there's going to be any stat, I want to show you because maybe you missed it. The problem with my company, and we're in a world of trouble. I've got some work to do. The problem with my company is the further down you get from Eric Thomas, you don't get the same product. The thing that blew my mind about Jeff changed the way I saw myself because when I spoke for Quicken Loans, Jeff made a comment. He says, Eric, you are as advertised. When I travel, I went on a cruise with my wife. Unfortunately, I didn't really know the celebrity was going. So when I got there every day, people were coming up to me, Mr. Thomas, I saw the YouTube. I'm like, not now, my wife's with me, not right now. She's really not interested in E.T. the Hip Hop Preacher. You about to get me in a world of trouble. I took a cruise to get away. What blew my mind is at the end of, even though I only had 2 or 3 minutes with them because I was gonna get in trouble, I got emails afterwards saying, I couldn't believe you were, I've watched you for 2 years. I've got your book, your everything, you, all your t-shirts, I got everything. And you were so personable. Like you were as energetic as you were on the video. That was really you. I can't believe, it's a dream come true. You are as advertised. But the problem in my company is you start going down the legs. And my agent is not as advertised. So the danger with my company is, when you say Eric Thomas, and my mind said, the further you go down, you may not find those people who. And what happens is, so we go back, you remember McDonald's. The problem with McDonald's is, you don't get the same experience at every McDonald's. That's the problem. The reason why I love Chick-fil-A, and everybody's got their issues, but the thing I love about Chick-fil-A, that no matter what Chick-fil-A you go to, it's consistent. Every Chick-fil-A you go to, they're gonna speak to you and act like we just, and that's what I love about Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A is smart enough to know that because of our brand, we cannot open up a franchise everywhere in America and we'll take the loss. Now, I'm not gonna go any further with that. I want you to catch what I just said. So when you drive in certain neighborhoods, you're not gonna see a Chick-fil-A. Listen to me very closely. Chick-fil-A's bathroom. See, I study. You just trying to pick up behaviors. Mm-mm. I'm studying people. The bathrooms in Chick-fil-A are exactly the same. They're as clean and everyone. I don't just eat. I go in the bathroom and say, oh, they had great customer service. Let me look at this bathroom. Every bathroom is the exact same. The problem with this company and the reason why it may not go where it wants to go is not because of Dan Gilbert. It's because of you. When we start going down the chain and we get to your department, you may not have the same behavior, or your staff may not have it, or you may not be able to produce them. You have them, but you can't produce them in them. And the further down you go, Burger King, the reason why Burger King is not what it used to be, they used to say you can have it your way. Well, I go to Burger King, and if I, depending on which one I go to, I'm not getting it my way. Somebody told me, what time you come in here? Did you see the clock? Yes, ma'am, I did see the clock. It's 9:45, we close at 10. I'm like, I'm sorry, I apologize. I want a little extra, man. Can I get an extra? You know that's an extra dollar. I have money. I didn't say that. I know it's extra, but I just asked, could I please have, could I have cheese, please? You know that 25 cents. I do. And I have 25 cents. I do. I'll give you 50. I just want cheese on my sandwich. That's all. No, are you hearing what I'm saying? Burger King, when Dave Thomas started Wendy's, he had a certain philosophy. And so what happens is every time he gets another brand, every time he gets another store, the challenge is, can he recreate himself in that brand? Are they gonna give the kind of service if Dave was there himself? That's why he did his commercials himself, because he wanted you to know who he was as a person. But the problem is when you go, you don't get the same thing. But when you go to Chick-fil-A, you always get a fresh sandwich. You don't get a cold. You may have to wait a second, but Chick-fil-A, you gotta go. I don't know if you've been before. Listen to me, Chick-fil-A, and they're closed on Sundays, by the way. And one of the most successful chains in America. Why? Because it's consistent all around. I went to a Chick-fil-A recently down in Alabama. They have to pay a parking attendant because they've got two lines that are so backed up. There's so many people in the restaurant that they have to pay somebody to tell people which way to go. You don't see that at Wendy's. Why? Because sometimes when you go to Wendy's, you may get cold fries. You don't realize it till you're halfway home and you hurt like cold fries. Right? They knew the fries was cold. They got the number up there. Why? But guess what? They don't see this as, you said it earlier. The problem is they don't see this as their company. They're just making some money. So if your fries are cold or hot, that has absolutely nothing to do with how much money I make. some kind of way. I don't know what happened at Chick-fil-A, but he's got them to believe that this is our company. And so when I work the register, I work the register like I own this company. You got to teach them how to do that. You got to take the focus away from how much money do I make to this is mine. Because once it becomes yours, once you own it, nobody has to tell you to go the extra mile. You'll go the extra mile because it's yours. You have ownership in it. You have partnership in it. You got to show them that. You don't see commercials about McDonald's chicken, right? Because they invented the chicken sandwich. They just do it right. And so every time you go and you get the right chicken sandwich, you want to keep coming back. Why? Because you had the same experience. Every person you talk to on that phone, every loan you do, it better be the same exact experience. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It's an experience. And the problem is I get on the phone with some of you, I don't get the same experience. I love Wendy's. I love the chicken sandwich. What happened was I got it one or two times cold. And I, Carl, what was our favorite sandwich, Carl?
Number 7 made like a single with everything and cheese.
That was our thing. When was the last time we've been to Wendy's?
Months.
Maybe years. We got two bad experiences and the whole franchise took a hit now, the whole franchise. We went to Howell, it was terrible. It was cold, the fries was cold. We was in the airport, said no more Wendy's. And every city that we can get to or what, where do we eat at? Chick-fil-A. If we just hear this once, 30-minute drive, rent a car. Let's rent a car. but it's all the way inside. That's okay. We've got to be back to speak. Don't worry about the speaking engagement. I'll call and tell them to stall. Let's get over and get us a sandwich real quick. Right? We love the experience so much that we were in the airport. What was that? Charlotte's Airport Sunday. And we were all ready to go and we forgot. It's closed on Sunday. Hurt. We were hurt. I brought him a little sandwich back and he was looking at the sandwich like, Eric, what is this? It was a gyro and some rice. He like, Eric, what is this? What happened? I said, you know what happened. It's closed. He said, this is okay. But he said, it might even be good, but I had a taste in my mouth for Chick-fil-A. Listen to me. You laughing. They better have a taste in their mouth for Quicken Loans when they get off the phone with you. A taste in their mouth. May they never go to another company. May they never think about another company. When they get off the phone with you, may they say, we need to go buy. Can we buy stocks in your company? Can we invest? That's the experience ought to be so powerful that they're ready to invest in the company when they get off the phone with you. Time I come out here, especially in the winter, and pray at 3:00 in the morning. It just reminds me so much of when I was homeless. Man, this 3:00 in the morning thing has changed my life, man. It felt like it's -2 degrees out here. But it's not the cold, it's not, you know, the numbness in your hands, the numbness in your feet. Like, that's not what it is. It's when it's dark and you gotta walk by yourself. When I was going through my worst, you know, points in life, I had my mama, you know, I had my grandma, you know what I'm saying? I had my cousins, you know, but when I was homeless, it was dark and I was by myself, you know? So I know for a lot of you, the year started off, you know, as dark as the other year started off. You're as lost as you were before, you had no clarity. I get it, your confidence is shattered. My confidence was so bad when I was homeless. I couldn't walk with my head up. I couldn't have my shoulders up. I couldn't stick my chest out. And so I know what you're going through. So for me, it's like, how can I help? You know, I read your DMs, you know? I read them. I see the texts you send me. I see when I'm preaching, I see the comments you make, you know? And I was like, God, how can I help? And so, you know, I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to let them get through January, you know? And I'm going to let them see if this is going to be a different year. For a lot of you, it's not. Here's what we're going to do in February. I'm going to walk with you because I know what it's like to walk alone. So I'm going to walk with you in your darkest points of your life, right? God changed my life at 3:00 in the morning, and that's why I'm still doing it. I was 16 years old. I'm 53 now. I'm still getting up in the morning, and I'm still walking and talking with God. And so I'm going to introduce you to the system that God gave me. Every day, we're gonna do it for an entire month. I'm gonna give you that system. I'm gonna give it to you for free. If you wanna get on the other side and like live and be and do and have everything God had planned for you, I'm telling you, all you gotta do is click that link. Together, we're gonna get on the other side. It's your boy, ET. If you're ready to make the rest of your life the best of your life, I'll see you February 1st.